And the data section, remember, all the main thing about the data sections is A, keep them separate. Don't mix range of motion with muscle testing. Keep all your diagnostic categories 100% separate in their own category. Number two, only put the positive findings on the initial exam and the exam at MMI. You do not want to clutter the attorney and whoever's looking at this. They don't want to just see a bunch of crap. This is like right to the point. This is the data that's most important in this category, period. Whatever is left over in that category, if you're in the muscle strength category, it goes into that addendum. That's it. And then all the re-exams go in, all the muscle exams from the initial exam, the first re-exam, all of them just get dumped into it. And that's literally copy and paste. There's no organizational structure at all. You're just taking all that material of that category and just putting it in that addendum. That's the mess of the narrative report. The true narrative report is not the mess. That's the clean, precision, organized component. Remember, this is the single most important document in personal injury. And remember, when you talk to attorneys, it's one of the first things they'll say. They'll say, well, let me see, excuse me, they'll say, let me see your narrative report. Or let me see an example of your narrative report. See? And that's one thing you want to do. You at least want to have a template of a narrative report, even if you haven't filled one out yet. You should have a template, and then you should be able to explain it. This goes here, this goes here, this goes, this is what we do in these sections, and that's what this section is. So it's well organized and format to, you're not just throwing shit against the wall and making them run for cover. Okay?